Well, it's good to see you this evening, and I hope that as you enjoy the concert this evening, our time of worship really is what it is, but a time of worship. Brother Dennis will be coming to share a word with us in a moment. At the very end, we'll take a love offering, and I want to encourage you to be gracious in your love offering. This family travels around the country, and we're very grateful to have them. Not only do they sing, "You Know My Heart," but they as a family represent service to the King. And you and your family, that's the thing. And I, of course, I love the singing, okay? And I enjoy that. And I enjoy the preaching and so forth. But what I see is a family walking with the Lord. And I want to encourage all of our families to do the same and to find your ministry and find your mission and engage in it as a family. If you'll do that, God will bless you. Well, as you enjoy the music, you're probably wondering, how can I pick up some of these CDs? And Katie has a song out. The boys have, not a song, a CD. She has her own CD. I told Brother Dennis this morning, I said, that girl sounds like she's right out of the hills of Tennessee. She's more country than all three of those boys put together. But we really enjoyed her this morning as well. And she has a CD. They have multiple CDs, both in the foyer and out here in the hallway. Please buy those, okay? Buy those and enjoy them as you travel along. And you say, well, you know, Southern Gospel, you know, for some of you, I understand that's not your first choice of music. That's okay. There's a preference in music. But listen, when you put that CD in there, the lyrics are clear. They're godly. And you'll never have to wonder, what did they say? You know, what was that? What was that song? You'll at least know what that's about. Well, buy them and be gracious. Let me pray for us, and I want to let these boys go ahead and come on up, and I'll turn things over to Brother Dennis. We'll get right into this. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for your goodness to us, and we just want to praise you tonight. We want to thank you for our salvation. We want to thank you that when we look to heaven, we look to a real place. We don't have to wonder about it, that you are... You're preparing a place for us, a place that is, Lord, comprised of many mansions, a place where we're going to enjoy, and we want to bring everybody we can with us. Lord, help us to be burdened for someone around us that needs to know you, that they might know you and that you might know them and that they might spend eternity with you. Father, we're praying for that, friends, family, people we know tomorrow morning. As everyone in this sanctuary goes out into the highways and byways and work, God, burden their hearts for someone, I pray. Lord, bless the worship service tonight. These boys and Katie and Brother Dennis, whole family, Lord, bless them in Jesus' name. Amen.
And I lift my voice to worship you, my soul. Rejoice, take. shed many tears, but patience has stood by my side. But when I hear Satan say, you're not even saved, you're traveling down the wrong track, I recall once again where grace was stood sin. Down memory's lane, I take him back. I take him back to the time at an old-fashioned meeting when the presence of God filled the air. When the saints were singing a praise and glory, sweet melody seasoned with prayer. When one simple sermon from an old-fashioned preacher was like life to a poor dying slave, I walked him down the aisle to a place at the altar where grace fell and I know I got saved. Abode in my heart. The sun now shines brighter, my burden is lighter since Jesus gave me a new start. My songs have been changed, my life rearranged, my journey is now a new road. And when that old accuser tells me I'm a loser, I remind him how he lost my soul. Back to the time at an old-fashioned meeting when the presence of God filled the air. When the saints were singing a praise and glory, sweet melody seasoned with prayer. When one simple sermon from an old-fashioned preacher was like five to a poor dying slave, I walked him down the aisle to a place at the altar where grace fell and I know I got saved. One simple sermon from an old-fashioned preacher was like five to a poor dying slave. I walked him down the aisle to a place at the altar where grace fell and I know I got saved. Upon Calvary and the man in the middle.
coming? Don't you know there's a football game on television tonight? That's why God created TiVo, amen? And thank you so much. What a blessing, Brother Joe, to have your people be so faithful to the house of God. And I know why you're here, because you love Jesus. That's why you're here. Well, we're so honored to be able to be a part of this service tonight. And my, we enjoyed the services this morning. Had a great time of fellowship. And man, the pastor talked about next Sunday and over this series of weeks about the series of heaven and hell. And man, I thought of something. He was talking about bringing them and then offering to take them to eat lunch or afterwards. That's a great way to get people to come to church, because everybody has to eat, you know. And we after lunch today, we were kind of tired. We had a crazy week, as I said this morning. And so Pastor and Miss Cheryl were so kind to let us just kind of just rest on the bus this afternoon. And so I told them, we'll just go pick something up. I found that Popeye's chicken around the corner. I tell you, you want to get somebody to come to the house, offer them some Popeye's chicken. That's some good stuff right there. Hey, man, was that good or what? Man, that was awesome. But I tell you, we have an opportunity tonight to feast at the Lord's table. And I love him, and I praise the Lord, don't you? I love that gospel singing. Hey, I like all kinds of gospel music. I heard some gospel jazz the other day. It was gospel music with a jazz style. It was beautiful. And I love all kinds of gospel. The contemporary praise, whatever. Man, I love it all. I like bluegrass gospel. I like this kind of gospel. I'm not even sure what kind of gospel they're singing as far as style. It's kind of a mixture. But I know one thing. It's pure gospel. And as long as it's pure gospel, that's all we all care about. Amen? Just give me Jesus. Give me a message about him. Give me a message of forgiveness. Give me a message of hope. That's why I love gospel music. Because it's uplifting and it's glorifying to God. And it tells us how we can find hope in life. I can't believe people making millions of dollars tonight singing about getting drunk and acting goofy. But they sing songs about, you know the songs I'm talking about? She broke my heart, so I broke her fangs. Those kind of songs. I call it America's music. Well, it may be, but I want a song from another world, don't you? Singing about the solid rock that'll never stop loving us. Well, I introduced our kids this morning. Hey, anybody here? Let me ask this. Anybody here for the very first time in your life, first time ever to come into First Baptist Church of Groves? Raise up your hand if this is your first time at this. But raise them up high, because I got a gift for you. Right over here and right here. Cody, come here. I want you to go grab those CDs right down there. I want to give these people a CD right now as a remembrance of your gift, remembrance of your time to our church here tonight, the First Baptist. I say our church, I feel like I'm at home. Raise your hand if this is your first night ever, first time ever. Give each of these ladies a CD. And then back here, there's some. And this is the boys and Katie singing. And we just want you to remember your time here. Raise your hand back there. Somebody else, right over here. Hey, the pastor's got his hand up. All right, well, I said all that and did all that to welcome you. Welcome you to one of the greatest churches in this county, this area. And if I lived in this area, this would be my church home. I love this church. And I love Dr. Joe Worley. Thank you, Brother Joe, for letting us come. These are my children. This is our son Keith, our oldest son Keith Thomas, 19 years old. This is our middle son Cody. He's 17 years old. This guy is a hunter. He's a fisherman. The other day we was walking out to the garage after the surgery I had. He was helping me do some stuff. And, ooh, I'm not going to forget you. We were walking out to the garage. I was going to bring something in about just putting some Christmas stuff up or something. And I said, Cody, come out to the garage with me, because I couldn't pick up a lot of stuff then. And we were walking out the garage, and all of a sudden, he said, Dad, sort of whispering. I said, what, son? He said, look out there. There was three deer in our backyard. He said, I want to get my bow. I want to take that little one down right now. He wanted to shoot a deer in my yard. But he said, he didn't do it, but I wouldn't let him. I said, I'm going to throw a rock and scare that deer. You're not going to kill a deer in my yard. This guy's a hunter and fisherman, and I noticed he had pocket knives sticking out of his pants pocket. I don't know if you noticed that. Russ, this kid is a redneck right there, but he is. And then this is old Christopher. He loves music. I'm telling you, this kid lives for gospel music. And constantly singing, constantly finding us new songs. And of course, they love what they do, and I love loving what they do. And what a blessing, as you said, Pastor, to serve the Lord together as a family. These boys were at the National Quartet Convention this past September, and they were invited to sing because our family had a booth at the convention center there during the convention. 20,000 people there were not, the largest gathering of gospel singers and I think every group in America was there, and 20,000 people at the Louisville Fairgrounds there, Louisville, Kentucky, and these boys were invited to sing, and they were chosen that day as the best group of the day out of about 60 groups, and I was amazed. And because they were chosen, they were invited to sing on the main stage that night, and this broadcast worldwide, internet, and videoed, and then sang in front of that crowd on Wednesday night. And then on Saturday, because they won that deal on Wednesday, they were invited to a final best of the best. Each day's winner out of 450 groups, it was down to 10 groups. And those 10 sang in the showcase, and the panel was like an American Idol panel. Brother Steve Hurst of the famous Steve Hurst Music School and some other record industry and record and radio executives were there, and they were the judges, and they critiqued each group. Of course, we were scared to death. These boys were on pins and needles. All the other groups were adults, you know, and really awesome groups around the country. It's just a bunch of teenagers. And they got up and sang, and it came time for the judge. I was out at the booth taking our booth down because we had to be at First Baptist Owenton, Kentucky the next morning. Shows you how much faith I had. I was tearing down our booth when I got the word that the unanimous winner was those Irwin boys from Edgewood, Texas. Such an awesome job, and they were so received, and they're going to get to sing on the stage next year at the convention, and they got a record company offered them to do a free record for as a result in Tennessee in April, so that was a blessing. But the thing I loved about it, church, is that the judges said, you know why we picked your boys? Two reasons. Because the other groups were singing with soundtracks, but they had their voices stacked. In a studio, you can stack your voice, but you're actually three or four voices for one voice. Because we can tell your boys were the only voices on that tape. Your kids were actually singing. It wasn't this Milli Vanilli stuff. They were actually singing. Number two, here's the thing that I love as a dad, and you parents will appreciate this. They watch these kids, they interview them, they talk to them, they say, we love the sweetness. We love the fact they were sweet kids. Boy, as a parent, that's what I want. Amen. I love that. I appreciate their athletic ability and all that stuff, academics and everything, but I want their heart to be pure for God. Well, here's the song that they sang and what they used to win that award. And it's the title song on one of those CDs that Brother Joe was showing you. It's called What Really Matters in Life. And it's, the thing I love about it is this song really gets at what's going on in America. This song says what really matters in life is your faith. What matters in life is your family. And what matters in life are your friends. Amen. And so I love this song. And I wrote this 17 years ago. When Cody was born, Pop Lee, Arnold's daddy, came to the hospital when Cody was born. And I wrote this song the day after he was born, just out of the awesome thing of seeing another baby born. And never dreamed 17 years ago when I wrote this song at a Best Buy parking lot in Mesquite, Texas. I never dreamed we'd be standing in First Baptist Church Grove 17 years later singing it right here for you. But anyhow, I love the song, and I hope you enjoy it.
People so busy on the treadmill of life, they're running but going nowhere. Priorities are tearing us apart. It's time to stop and search our hearts about what really matters in life. Let's peace with God to walk in His light. Thank the Jesus Christ. The love of friends, your kids and your wife. That's what really matters in life. It's not houses or land or some paycheck in your hand. For these things will all pass away. But the things that really matter will stand the test of time. Through eternity we're gonna say about what really mattered in life. Well, it's peace with God to walk in His light. Faith in Jesus Christ. Really matters in life. Well, it's having peace with God and walking in His light. The faith in Jesus Christ. The love of friends, your kids and your wife. That's what really matters. That's what really matters. Oh, that's what really matters in life. understand or even hear, looking for answers for your needs. But if all you see is me, Lord, help us stand beside so they can see the one who died. I can't point the way, but only you can say. I stood there in wonder, someone so guilty had just been set free. My chains were broken, I felt born again, at the moment that mercy walked in. Mercy walked in and pleaded my case, called to the stand, God's saving grace. The blood was presented to cover my sin. Forgiven when mercy walked in. Mercy walked in and pleaded my case, called to the stand, and God's saving grace. The blood was presented to cover my sin. Forgiven when mercy walked in.
Well, as Dad said, it's such an honor to be back here at First Baptist Groves and be back with Brother Joe. It's such an honor. This next song we're going to do is a song that they let me sing on it. And the first verse talks about how Joseph, at the time when he was sold by his brothers, he didn't understand what God was doing. He didn't fully understand what God was doing at the time. And that's the truth. A lot of things in our lives, no matter what you're going through, sometimes we don't understand what God's doing. And you just got to trust God, no matter what you've been through, what you're going through, what you're going to go through. You just got to trust God that He knows what He's doing. That's what the song talks about, when God has another plan.
Forsaken by his brothers, didn't fit the scene. Being made a slave was not what Joseph dreamed. The coat of many colors was stained with blood and lies. But from this divine appointment, a ruler would arise.
Another plan.
Walk on and just say yes, when God has another plan. Be assured that He knows best.
When all your dreams are shattered, trust in His sufficient grace.
We don't have to understand. By God's design, if you could see tomorrow with a view from heaven's throne, every unexpected struggle has led you closer home.
When God has another plan,
walk on and just say yes. When God has another plan, best.
When all your dreams are shattered, trust in His sufficient grace.
We don't have to understand.
When God has another plan,
walk on and just say yes. When God has another plan,
trust in His sufficient grace.
We don't have to understand
when God has another plan.
No, we don't have to understand,
oh, when God has another plan.
Stuff down here we have to worry about. Crime. You know, we have to have security systems in our home up in Edgewood, Texas, just north of Canton. We plan to drive there tonight after church. And we have a security system on our house. We leave home. Of course, my mother-in-law lives with us, and she watches the house and helps our ministry. But most of us haven't known we have a security system, because this day and time, we almost have to. That's at my house. But at my home, we're not going to have any security systems up there. Amen? At my house, out there on Van Zandt County Road 1925, Russ, I've got kind of a county road, and the county commissioner sends a truck by, you know, especially in election time. He sends a truck by and fills those chuck holes up with that rock and asphalt and stuff at my house. But at my home, the Bible says the streets are made of pure gold. Down here, gold's $2,000 an ounce. Matter of fact, they operated on my eyes. Since you're my family, I won't tell you, I don't know if I told anybody this, but you know how they helped me blink my eye out? They stuck a piece of gold in my eyelid. I'm carrying around gold in my head, folks. Don't get the secret out, though. I'll be in trouble because it's $2,000 an ounce. But up there in our home, they make streets out of it. No big deal up there, amen. Gates of pearl, streets of gold, walls of jasper. That's at our home, rather. Hey, the other day I had to make a house payment. I'm still paying for my house. But listen, at my home, it's already paid for, amen? Oh, I can't wait to see our home. We're going to be there as a family of God one day. And this song she's going to sing, the thing says, a lot of things are going to be different. There's not going to be any bad news, booze, or bars when we're going, amen? I like this song. It gets up and goes. It's called I'm Gonna Move.
I can't wait to see the fire.
God with fear as the night began to fall. One more lost lamb, then I heard the shepherd's call.
He saw my steps as they walked right into the dark.
Jesus shed his blood, and that power in that blood is sufficient and more than powerful enough to save every soul that's ever lived. Now we know the Bible says that so many say no to Christ, so many say no to his call, but if you're saved tonight, it's because of God's marvelous grace. Amen? I'm thankful for that call. And then after we're saved, and our flesh and influences come in our life. And sometimes a child of God, we like sheep, we want to stray off. And I'm thankful our great shepherd, the Lord Jesus, even after we're saved for sure, he's not going to stray too far, amen? By his spirit, by his word, by his conviction, he calls us back to himself, to fellowship with the Lord. We're so blessed. Now, they're going to sing this song. I know they've done this at least a couple of years here, probably 3 years straight, but it's one of our favorite songs. It's on that CD we gave you. It's a song called I Have Been Blessed. And we are so blessed tonight. We're blessed to know Jesus. Amen. Amen. Listen, if you're not saved, you don't know Jesus, you're blessed because tonight you can know him. You can be saved tonight. And if you're a Christian, all the blessings that come from knowing Christ, fellowship with God, peace with God, a home in heaven, the forgiveness of God, all that, I mean, you could just go on and on. And then a Christian family, we sang about it. God's given us a wonderful family. We're blessed in our family life. We're blessed in our financial life. God, one of us is going to sleep under a bridge tonight, amen? We've all got a place to pillow our head and sleep. And then, of course, we have that physical strength of God. And then we have friends. I tell you, I have really enjoyed meeting Russ and Coco today, my new friends here. Have y'all been coming here a while, Russ? Well, amen. I just met them early on this morning and fell in love with them. And I love, you know what I love about being an evangelist? For 38 years, we have met people just like this dear couple. And you, many of you that we've known through the years, to know the family of God around the country. We get to do this every night. We're blessed to have so many friends. And you are. Thank God for friends. And so they're going to sing about this, a song of praise and thanksgiving to God. Just some reminders tonight of how we're blessed. Then we're going to have a time of decision before we close. Okay. When he walks among us, all that he does, all of his mercy, all of his love, if the pen of a writer could write every day, not even this world could ever contain how much I've been blessed. The warmth in the winter, flowers in spring, the laughter of summer, and the changing of leaves, food on my table, and a good place to sleep. Clothes on my back and shoes on my feet, I have been blessed. I have been blessed. God is so good to me. Precious are his thoughts of you and me. No way I could count them. There's not enough time. So I'll just thank him for being so kind. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed. Arms that can raise, a voice that can talk, hands that can touch, and legs that can walk, ears that can listen, and eyes that can see. Oh, I've got to thank him as long as I breathe. Cause I have been blessed. We live in a country, it's the greatest on earth. Our flag stands for freedom and what it is worth. She stands in the harbor, Miss Liberty called. All have gained some, but some gave it all for me to be blessed. I have been blessed. God is so good to me. Precious are his thoughts of you and me. No way I could count them. There's not enough time. So I'll just thank him for being so kind. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed. Father and mother, nurtured and raised. Sisters and brothers, and the memories made. Our pastor to lead us, this altar to pray. Stripes that can heal and blood that still saves. Oh, I have been blessed. He's my shoulder to lean on when I am down. The rock where he leads me,
when I'm overwhelmed.
The place where He hides me under His wings. It's not just a song, it's the reason I sing. 'Cause I have been blessed. I have been blessed. God is so good to me. Precious are His thoughts of you and me. No way I can count them, there's not enough time. So I'll just thank Him for being so kind. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed. God, you've been good.
So
words, or think about the message of the songs. You heard the voice say, Keith talked about back when he was saved over here at 7th Street Baptist Church. We were in revival. And that night, I'll never forget the night he saved Keith. Cody also was saved in the same revival meeting over here at 7th Street Baptist Church. I was saved at Mount Lebanon Baptist Camp on June the 26th, 1966. Christopher was saved in a revival meeting in Canton, Texas. You know, I'm thankful that if we know Jesus, we can go back to the time and the place when we know we trust in Him. Amen? And if you're saved, I rejoice and challenge you as I did this morning. Church, let's live for Christ. Let's serve the Lord and let's witness and let's do His work when it comes. But if you're here tonight without Jesus, we would not dare leave this service without at least the Lord's extending an invitation to you. He has invited you to come and be saved tonight. We'll give you the same opportunity someone gave us the night I got saved. That's to come and tell the pastor of your desire to know Jesus Christ as your Savior. Nobody's going to heaven by osmosis or by accident. Jesus said you must be born again. There's an experience, just like your physical birth was an experience. There was a day, there was a time. On September the 8th, 1953, I have my birth certificate that signifies the time, the day, and the place I was born physically. There was a birth experience physically. But aren't you glad tonight we can be born the second time? We can be born again, and that too is a definite experience of salvation. A born-again experience. Has that happened to you? Have you been saved? If not, it just may be one tonight, or it may be several. We pray that you would come and trust in Jesus. Just come as you are. You say, well, I don't want to be a Baptist. We're not talking about being a Baptist. We're talking about becoming a Christian. Well, I don't want to join this church. Well, that may not be where God leads you, but we're not even talking about joining the church. We're talking about going to heaven. Amen? And we're sure talking about not going to hell. So tonight, I want us to stand together. Would you stand with us tonight? Our pastor, Brother Worley, is coming. And he's going to be standing here. And this altar is open for anyone that wants to come and pray. Christians, give a prayer need, a family need. We'd love to pray with you. If you want to bring a friend or just get by yourself and pray tonight. Maybe something in one of these songs, some praise, some word, some message has touched your heart. And you, before we leave tonight and start this new week, just like to get along with God and say, Lord, I want to live for you this week. Amen. But if you're not saved, a teenager, college age, adult, man or woman, it matters not. Brother Worley is going to be standing right here. And if you need to be saved, you can be. This can be your day of salvation. If you come, we're going to rejoice with you. All I can say is we're going to rejoice with you. Let's pray. Father, thank you for giving us this time of praise and worship tonight, testimonies, fellowship. Thank you for these songs the children have presented. Thank you for the truth of the gospel. Jesus, they sang about how you died on the cross for sinners like us. For that, we thank you. We thank you for shedding your blood to pay for our sins. We thank you for tasting death on our behalf. Lord, your Bible, your word says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, I pray tonight that someone who realizes they're a sinner, someone who's never been saved, would come tonight and say, I want to receive the gift of Christ. I want to receive the gift of forgiveness and salvation. I want to be saved. Oh God, open a heart, touch a heart, change a life. We pray in Jesus' name. And then, Lord, take the songs and touch your Christians, touch your people. Help us to leave here, nothing else, praising you for what you've done in our lives. Bless now this time of decision in these moments, and we'll thank you and praise you.